Why doesn't Microsoft just dump the registry? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I get from time to time. Why is there a registry? It seems like so many problems with Windows center in the registry. Why not replace it with something else that works? Well, to be clear, the registry isn't really broken. The registry is actually a fairly robust database technology, and honestly, not a lot more. However, the way it's used often leads to problems that people believe is related to the registry when in fact it's related to the data that the applications are putting in the registry. The pragmatic reason we will never leave the registry behind in Windows is that it is simply too entrenched. Be it applications, Windows itself, the registry is tightly woven into Windows and the Windows ecosystem. So it's not going to go away. One of the common responses I get to the registry being a different way of storing information is that why aren't we just using any files? Well, to be clear, there is nothing, and I mean nothing, preventing an application from doing exactly that. Applications can use all the any files they want and completely ignore the registry. However, the registry actually provides a bunch of features and functionality that, while not really all that important for the home user, is incredibly important for the corporate user. And you can bet which customer base gets more attention from Microsoft. The registry, like I said, it's just a database. It allows applications to be portable. And by portable here, I really mean in the corporate environment, you can sign in on one machine and then go sign in on another machine and have all of your settings automatically transferred. That's a side effect of the registry. The registry itself also has an incredibly robust security model, which means that access to information stored in the registry can be restricted to any number of the accounts on your machine, and it can be restricted at an extremely granular level, at the key level. Whereas in any file scenarios, that file is either completely available or it's just not available. It's an all or nothing kind of scenario. Again, these are things that as home users, you and I probably don't really care about, but it is something that is baked into Windows. Now, the registry does have a failing, and that is the complexity of how information is stored within the registry. There's an intended order to what goes in there. Unfortunately, there's so many different things and so many different scenarios for information to be saved and recorded and set and changed that not all applications actually do the right thing. Some may store their personal settings in one place, others in a different place. They may pay attention to different keys, etc., etc. That, more than anything else, is what leads to the configuration issues we often associate with the registry. But my claim is that those configuration issues would still exist for almost any other replacement technology that actually solved all the problems that the registry is trying to solve. Like I said, the registry is just a database. It's a fairly interesting database technology. But it, in and of itself, is not the problem. It's what goes into the registry, how it's organized, how it's not organized, and how it's misused. Anyway, like I said at the beginning, it ain't going away. It's there for the duration of Windows itself. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/11680. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.